routine would look like. Okay, I have my release spray. I'm going ahead. Hi. She's not worried about what I've got in my hand. I come up and I do my polarity sweeps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I've already done myself, but just in case. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Want some release? You can offer it to them. Yummy. Okay, and I just come in here, spray the weather, make them comfortable with what I'm doing. Spray this entire meridian here. They come in under here, pardon me, a little cold, getting underneath the tail to the last point underneath here. Making sure I get release in there. So that was the governing meridian up top. Now I'm putting on the conception meridian down here, back to their navel. I come up here and I spray his pecs down real good. So I'm going to work his K27. I'm waiting to feel it break through here at the top of his pecs. It might feel hard or like a rock, and you just want to keep working it. It's just like this, up, down in here until it breaks through and your fingers fit in nice and easy. And you're looking for any lathering. The lathering will tell you if it needs more work. Job. This side actually looks pretty good. I'm gonna work the other one from this side. This one's a little tighter. Right. And now I'll come in and I'll put the release on his head. I spray it onto my hand. Good boy. And you can kind of see how your horse is comfortable. You can block their eye, see if he'll let you. He is letting me. Good boy. This dog, good boy. And I'm basically just going to drench his whole head. But really important to get in between his ears, behind, all around the ear. Again, I'm looking for any lathering. If I see lathering, there's a little bit lathering going on right here. I'll be sure to work it a little bit longer. Good. Good boy, Pistol. Yeah. You okay? Awesome. Yummy? I'm gonna go work the other side of his face. Getting a lot of lathering over his eye, over on this side, just beneath his ear. Now I'm going into the bladder sweeps, which starts right in the inside of his eye, up through the ears, both hands traveling together down the neck. You're feeling for any cold spots or patchy spots. Come down here, through the groove, Red bladder.
67. Right here.
And you keep your connection as you come back. And we're gonna do this three times on each, sorry baby, three times on each side. He's a little sticky to me right here. So I'll take a little sticky again right here. So I'll take my time going over that. And with each time you go over, you should feel it. You should feel the flow increasing more and more with each passing. Good. Good boy. On to the other side. Starting on the inside of the ear, or I'm sorry, inside of the eye, the inside of the ear, down his neck. It's a little patchy right here, a little patchy right here, similar to his other side. Take your time with this. You can go slower. I'm going just a little bit quicker for demonstration purposes, but don't feel like you have to be rushed. Good. Good boy, that feels better. Now I'm going to apply the Miracle Spray, also known as Hoof Spray. Good boy. Hi. You can offer it to them in their mouth, see if they want to drink a little of it. Oh, yeah. Oh, he loves it. This is just a special recipe of essential oils and the Dynamite Liquid Trace Minerals mixed in distilled water. Good boy. Just knocking off some mud here real quick. We're going to apply it around his coronet bands down here. You can put it into your hand directly or onto him directly, however you choose. I like to be generous with it. Really working it in. Okay, and if his hooves were cleaned off, they got a little mud on them, I'd spray it directly on to the hoof and watch it soak it up. Also, I like to spray it under here. Can I have your hoof? Good boy. Particularly if they have this crack here, it's susceptible to bacteria, so you really want to soak it right there. Let it absorb a little before you just drop it onto the ground. And you'll see some of these hoofs just soak it up. They love this. This is good if your horse has thrush. It'll clean that right up. Oh, baby. This also, I'm working the ting point. And just gets all the energy flowing and going. Good boy. Good boy. I'm also feeling for calcifications while I'm down here to see if I need to apply any of the Dynamite wound balm and do some sweats on here. His feet feel pretty good, but I would recommend a sweat on him to help kind of liquefy, gelify this calcium so the body can absorb it. I'd also recommend doing his back feet with the sweat balms. It's got a little calcification on the inside here on both. his might only take two or three sweats. You just have to kind of monitor it. You want it to turn, it'll start to feel kind of like jelly, and that's how you know it's working. You don't want to blister him and leave it on too long, so usually one day on, one day off does the trick. Good boy.